As part of second list of Horizon 2 phase project, Philippine Navy embarked on the acquisition of a shore-based missile system that can be used to defend against naval surface threats and with a potential secondary role of attacking land targets. The shore-based anti-ship missile system acquisition project intends to acquire at least 3 batteries worth of truck-mounted mobile land-based missile systems, networked to the armed forces of the Philippine C4I Star system that includes air and naval surveillance and targeting platforms, and potentially linked to Allied surveillance and targeting data. This project of the Philippine Navy is the outcome of their disappointment over Philippine Army decision to shelve an old project, the shore-based missile system, which was cancelled back in 2015 by the Philippine Army leadership led by then Philippine Army Command General Lieutenant General Hernando Iribarri, who decided that the Philippine Army would rather spend the 6.5 billion pesos budget of the project for other essential projects. One of the main purposes of the cancelled Philippine Army SBMS project was to assist the Philippine Navy in providing limited anti-access, area denial, A2, AD, capabilities in the West Philippine Sea including the Calayan Island Group, despite its limited range if deployed in Palawan. The idea was to help give the Marines a better chance to fight off a potential naval invasion of the Calayan Island Group by Chinese or any other potential enemy force. Back then, the Philippine Army has selected the IMI Systems Coast and Island Defense System, which is essentially 2 batteries of land-based rocket launcher systems based on the IMI Lynx rocket missile launching system, and the IMI Extended Range Artillery Guided Rocket Munition. With the Philippine Navy left out by the cancellation of the Philippine Army's SBMS project, the service then made a commitment to make sure that they will have their own shore-based missile system, and won't be reliant on the Philippine Army. This time, instead of a guided rocket system, both services are after an actual surface-to-surface missile system, which can do sea skimming flight and course changes while flying to its target, something the guided rockets like the IMI Extra cannot do. Philippine Navy and Philippine Army considered several models, including Russian, Indian, Korean, and European solutions. In the end, both services agreed on acquiring India's BrahMos land-based missile system. Reasons for BrahMos selection are as follows. First, the Philippine government has been actively promoting an independent foreign policy that is friends with all, enemies of none. This includes expanding its sources of weapon systems, which includes considering products from India in which the Philippines has a growing relationship with. Second, both services agreed to have a supersonic missile for consideration, rather than the usual subsonic missile used by most Western countries. A supersonic missile would be more difficult to intercept by hard-kill solutions like gun and missile-based close-in weapon systems due to its speed and ability to close the gap faster. Third, having a supersonic missile means having a bigger kinetic energy upon impact. It means that a single missile could have devastating effects even to ships as large as a destroyer or cruiser, not just because of the warhead it carries, but also the force it brings at such speed. Fourth, supersonic missiles also cover distances at a shorter time than subsonic missiles, which gives the target a smaller reaction time. Fifth, the BrahMos missile carries a 300-kilogram semi-armor-piercing warhead, which can penetrate and damage even the toughest ship hull armor plating. Sixth, while Russia can also offer supersonic missiles, Katsa issues remain a problem. Going with India means buying something comparable without the Katsa issues with it. And lastly, the pricing is very competitive for the BrahMos missile system. Apparently comparable Western products are far more expensive and more difficult to obtain due to the system's tactical and strategic value. Despite the COVID-19 restrictions, as confirmation by Max Defense Philippines, online training has begun for selected Philippine Navy, or more specifically, Philippine Marine Corps personnel. This includes theories and basic knowledge on missile systems, and on operating and maintaining the BrahMos missile system specifically. It was also confirmed that India extend more than $100 million credit line to the Philippines for the acquisition of BrahMos missile, and just recently Philippine Department of National Defense and the Indian Ministry of Defense signed the implementing arrangement for procurement of defense materiel and equipment. This arrangement will be the basis for the acquisition of the BrahMos land-based coastal defense batteries by the Philippine Navy and Philippine Army, as well as the potential acquisition of other Indian-made defense articles under government-to-government arrangement. It remains to be seen whether or not both services will be after newer variant, which now has a 500-kilometer maximum range.